be here for game seven.
When you're in the Stanley Cup and you're in the playoffs, your team will have to overcome adversity in order to be successful.
Everyone loves to try to be positive, but down deep, you know, in your gut, you know it's only been done twice that a team has come back from being down 3-0.
That's what I'm proud of, to be part of that team that never quit.
First penalty of the game belongs to Philadelphia's Hartnell will go to the sin bin, and the Bruins get a power play.
The chart right side took the shot, big pad save, turn around, and Ryder scores. Boston has taken the 1-0 lead in game seven.
It looks like it's just going to be Danny Briere for knocking the helmet off.
This is a must kill. I've been in across the Philadelphia zone, wide on Carl, centered it, they score! Lucic going out of the net. 2-0 Boston.
It's not past Kimo teaming it up the right wing. Milan Lucic walking right in. Took a shot. He scores. Lucic has his second goal of the period. And Boston's opened the 3-0 lead in the first period of game seven.
You know, we start the game, and within a few minutes, it's 3-0 for them. I mean, I couldn't believe it. And I completely lost my focus.
That's just what the hell just happened. And we were down 3-0 right away.
This series has been all about coming back from improbable deficits. I got another one right here in game seven.
And I turned to the person I was with and I said, it's been a great run.
Now Peter Laviolette, I think, did use his timeout.
These guys had fought hard. I don't think they needed to be yelled at. There wasn't any reason to get worked up. What they needed was, a plan. And at that time, it was really just to score one goal.
Nothing comes easy out there, especially in the playoffs, especially in a game seven. So we hadn't given up the whole season long, so we weren't going to start that.
Big collision as Richards runs into Weidman. Here's Van Riemsdyk with a shot. Deflected. He scores! And the rookie, James Van Riemsdyk, has his first ever playoff goal. It comes with less than 3 minutes to go in the period and gives the Flyers some life.
It was a cannon, wasn't it? A rocket to the back of the net.
I was trying to just shoot it as hard as I could and go high with it, but it ended up hitting somebody's stick, I think, in front and barely squeaking through his leg. So it's kind of funny how hockey works sometimes.
It was at the end of the period. They went back into their dressing room, and all of a sudden, you know, it's all over again. We're coming back from 0-3 in the series. Now it was 0-3 in the game, and I think it put them back on their heels.
Sends it out in front, Briere in the right circle. Drags it in behind the net, Ripper on the tip, he scores! Danny Briere ties it! Do you believe this? Down 3-0, they force game seven. Down 3-0 in game seven, they've come back to tie.
Where I felt the game change was the entire second period. That's when it seemed like it became believable that we could come back from 3-1 at that point, and we could win this hockey game.
The Flyers are going on the power play. The Bruins guilty of too many men on the ice. Gagne for Leno. Leno to Richards. Richards shot redirected. Gagne shot. He scores! Simone Gagne! Can you believe it? Power play goal, and the Flyers all the way back now lead this thing 4-3.
At that particular point, I felt we were a team of destiny, that we were going to go all the way, and I was going to get another one of these, you know? But as it turned out, we fell a little short. We didn't fall that much short. That's a whole nother story.
Drew, no Stanley Cup, but memories that will live forever. Eddie Flyers fan. Back with more from the Wells Fargo Center after these messages.